Hello everybody. So let me go with the problem on input tax credit. See the problem. Following are the transactions of a taxable person in Karnataka for the month of November 2019. Compute total turnover and GST payable. So the location of the supplier is Karnataka, and what we are supposed to calculate is, here we are not supposed to calculate transaction value, but they have asked us to calculate total turnover. Total turnover means aggregate turnover na calculate madbeku. So what are the things to be considered in order to calculate the total turnover athwa aggregate turnover calculate madakke yavdella na inclusions yavdu athwa yavdu consider madbeku anta helbitu. All interstate supply, interstate agirabodu, interstate supply agirabodu, nil rated, exempted, non GST goods ivella consider madbekagutte. Exports are to be included while computing aggregate turnover. So yavadna consider madbardu anta helidre, if there are inward supplies idre, athwa if goods are purchased from unregistered dealer, so GST is payable on reverse charge mechanism, athwa if goods are supplied to job worker, so these are the transactions which have to be excluded. Included yavadu anta helidre ella supplies, it may be intrastate, interstate, exempted goods supply agirabodu, it may be nil rated goods, or it may be non GST goods. If these goods are supplied athwa ee riti supply transactions idre include madbeku. So if you go through the aggregate turnover theory, inclusions yavadu anta helidre, so avaga nimge gotagutte, aa base mele this problem has to be worked out. So supply to a taxable person in Mysore 5%, 1 lakh. So supply to a taxable person in Mysore, location of the supplier is Karnataka, place of supply is Mysore, so intrastate supply. Next is supply to a taxable person in Goa, nil rated anta helire, though nil rated anta helirbodu idu total turnover, it forms part of total turnover. Aggregate turnover alli now nil rated na torustivi, but we won't calculate GST calculate madabaru, total turnover column alli torusbeku. Supply to a taxable person in Bangalore, once again intrastate, GST rate is 12%, so it becomes 6% CGST and 6% SGST. Supply to a taxable person in Udupi at the instructions of a dealer in Jammu and Kashmir, 18% is the GST rate applicable, 4 lakh is the worth of the goods. Now if you see here, supply to a taxable person in Udupi, goods have been supplied to Udupi ke supply madyare, but on whose instruction? On the instruction of a third person. Oba third person heliradrinda Udupi ke supply madyare. So third person, where he is located? The dealer is located in Jammu and Kashmir. So now which place is to be considered as place of supply, whether it is Udupi or whether it is Jammu and Kashmir? Remember, when a third person instructs to supply the goods to another place, the place of the third party is to be considered as place of supply. And really, Jammu and Kashmir dealer adonu instruct madiradu Udupi ge supply madi anta helibuttu, hage Udupi alla, the place of supply will be Jammu and Kashmir. So now the what type of supply it becomes? It becomes interstate supply, so IGST is applicable. Supply to a unregistered dealer in unregistered person in Mangalore, so no problem, within the state CGST and SGST. Supply to SEZ developer in Bangalore, SEZ developer ge supply martaradu deemed export agutte, so exports are zero rated. But remember, all exports forms part of total turnover. Total turnover now tospekate, remember taxable turnover bare, total turnover bare. Total turnover rules yavadu anta helidre the aggregate turnover rules. So before going through this problem, just have a look on aggregate turnover inclusions and exclusions. Next is supply to a taxable person in Pondicherry 12%, so once again intrastate supply, IGST is applicable. Supply to a registered person in Pune, exempt, 12 lakh. So Pune ke supply martaradu, but it is interstate supply. But if you see here, the goods supplied are exempted goods, though it may be exempted goods or nil rated goods or non GST goods, it forms part of total turnover. Total turnover column alli now toslebeku, but CGST athwa now GST calculation yavade rithiyada GST apply agala. Export to China, so once again exports are zero rated, so zero rated supply. Supply to a unit of SEZ in Mysore na SEZ ge supply maartta iradu, deemed export zero rated. Supply to a taxable person in Udupi ge supply maartta iradu, so intrastate supply, CGST and SGST are applicable. GST rate is 12%, so 6% CGST, SGST 6%. Supply to a dealer in Belgaum, once again place of supply is Belgaum, within Karnataka, intrastate supply, GST, the type of GST applicable is CGST and SGST. So 28% at the header, CGST 14% and SGST 14%. Credit in electronic credit ledger, IGST 1,70,000, CGST 90,000, SGST 1,50,000. So credit in electronic credit ledger, it means there is input tax credit available. IGST input tax credit available is 1,70,000. CGST amount is 90,000. SGST amount is 1,50,000. Always remember, as per the latest amendment, CGST input tax credit only, SGST input tax credit only. But the IGST input tax credit has to be utilized to the full extent. So full extent, hege anta helidre 1,70,000 IGST input tax credit in there. First, it should be adjusted towards IGST output tax, towards the payment of IGST output tax. IGST input tax credit na IGST output tax credit against agi adjust madbekagutte. If still balance remains, then you can adjust the IGST input tax credit towards CGST and SGST equal agi adjust madabodu. But CGST rules hege, CGST input tax credit idre it should be utilized towards the payment of CGST output tax. And if any balance remains, IGST output tax can be paid using CGST input tax credit. SGST also, SGST input tax credit can be utilized towards payment of SGST output tax. If still balance remains, then that balance can be utilized towards the payment of IGST output tax. Let me go through the problem. Always remember here, in this problem, they have asked us to calculate total turnover, transaction value. Alla. Total turnover andre aggregate turnover. Nan agle helidange aggregate turnover alla yavadella include martive andre interstate supply, intrastate supply, nil rated goods, exempted goods, supply of exempted goods, supply of non GST goods. Next, export, goods exported. Next is goods supplied to SEZ, FTP, EHTP, EOU. If goods are supplied to these areas, these are considered as deemed exports. So idna nav enanta idna nav aggregate turnover alli consider martivi athwa total turnover alli consider madbekagutte. And which are the things which are to be excluded from aggregate turnover or total turnover? Any type of GST, it may be CGST, SGST, UTGST, IGST. These taxes are to be excluded. Then if there are any inward supplies, andre purchase yavadar idre adna consider madbardu while computing total turnover or aggregate turnover. Hage, if goods are purchased from unregistered dealer, on which tax is to be paid under reverse charge mechanism, so such transactions are to be excluded. But here, if you go through here, nodi nil rated ide, though it is nil rated, see calculation illa ide. Supply to a taxable person in Mysore, 5% is there. Total turnover 1 lakh. CGST 2.5% is 2500 to CGST, SGST 2500. Supply to a taxable person in Goa, nil rate. So Goa supply madiyare, it is nil rate. Though the goods supplied are nil rated goods, it forms part of total turnover. Total turnover thosbekagutte, but yavade reetiyada taxes levy mado hagilla athwa levy madlikagalla. Supply to a taxable person in Bangalore, 12% they have mentioned. Since the place of supply is Bangalore, within Karnataka, it becomes intrastate supply. So 12% means 6% CGST, SGST 6%. And this is very important. As per the instructions of a third party, as per the instructions of Jammu and Kashmir dealer, goods were supplied to Udupi dealer. Udupi dealer ki supply madiddu. Iga yara instruction prakara supply madiddu anta helidre, as per the instructions of Jammu and Kashmir dealer. So this transaction becomes interstate supply, IGST is applicable. Hence, on the value of 4 lakh, 18% IGST is applicable. Supply to a unregistered person in Bangalore, once again intrastate supply. Supply to SEZ developer in Bangalore, deemed exports agide, though it may be deemed export or export, they are zero rated. It forms export selladu, total turnover torsbekagutte, but no GST is levied. Supply to a taxable person in Puducherry or Pondicherry, once again it is interstate supply, IGST is applicable. Supply to a registered person in Pune, exempt, it means that exempted goods are supplied to Pune dealer. Pune dealer ki exempted goods na supply maadtidare. Though it may be exempted goods, aggregate turnover li athwa total turnover li naavu torslebekagutte. But since the GST is exempt, GST is not levied. Export to China, so it is once again zero rated supply. it forms part of total turnover. Next, it is zero rated, so no GST is not levied. Supply to SEZ in Mysore, once again, Mysore is not imported. To where the goods are supplied in Mysore, that you have to see. So to SEZ in Mysore, the goods have been supplied, so it becomes deemed export 0% or zero rated. Supply to a taxable person in Udupi, 12% they have mentioned. So within Karnataka, interest rate supply 6%, 6%, CGST 6% and SGST 6% are applicable. Supply to a dealer in Belgaum, once again 28% is the GST rate. So interest rate supply agiradarinda CGST 14%, SGST 14%. So based on this, we are going to get the total turnover as 69,80,000 and output tax as 1,90,100 CGST. SGST total comes to 1,90,100 and IGST comes to 1,68,000. Then the next important step is we have to compute the GST payable. Consider the output tax first. Total output tax payable as per our previous calculation is CGST 1,90,100, SGST 1,90,100, IGST 1,68,000. So then we are supposed to utilize the input tax credit. So first utilize the IGST. IGST input tax credit amount is 1,70,000. But namge 1,70,000 IGST input tax credit beda, yakandre IGST output tax irudu 1,68,000 matra. So hagagi utilize the IGST credit towards the payment of IGST only 1,68,000. Hagagi CGST no hage uliyutte, SGST also remains the same. Still IG in case of IGST 2,000 remains. That 2,000, if any amount remains in IGST electronic credit ledger, or input tax credit, IGST, that can be utilized towards the payment of CGST and SGST equally. So, 2,000 is equal to CGST and SGST output tax credit, we can adjust. Still, CGST 1,89,100 remains and SGST 1,89,100 remains. So the next step is utilize the CGST and SGST under the same head that you utilize markoli. So under CGST you have 90,000 and under SGST you have 1,50,000. So 90,000 CGST, SGST 1,50,000. So thereby the output tax remains students. CGST output tax 99,100 is to be paid and SGST amount to be paid is 39,100. I hope you can understand. Remember, IGST input tax credit has to be considered first. So first it has to be utilized to the full extent. Debt extent use Marbek. We have 1,70,000 in the electronic credit ledger, but we don't require 1,70,000 here. Like the output tax is 1,68,000. Use only 1,68,000. So still how much remains in the input tax, in the IGST input tax credit is 2,000. R 2,000 you have to utilize to the debt extent. So, ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಉಳಿದಿರೋದನ್ನ CGST ಮತ್ತೆ SGST ಗೆ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ CGST ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಉಳಿಯುತ್ತೆ, SGST 1,89,100 ಹಾಗೆ ಉಳಿಯುತ್ತೆ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಈಗ CGST ಲಿ CGST ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಏನಿದೆ ಅದು CGST ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಯೂಟಿಲೈಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ, ಹಾಗೆ SGST ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಏನಿದೆ ಅದು SGST ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಗೆ ಯೂಟಿಲೈಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಸೊ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ದ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ರಿಮೈನ್ಸ್.